The Ministry of Secondary Education has developed a distance learning platform for students of secondary education in Cameroon. A series of lessons taught by qualified teachers for secondary school students. Under the stewardship of Professor Pauline Nalovalyonga in collaboration with the Ministry of Posts and Telecommunications, CAMTEL, CRTV, and UNESCO, we are introducing distance learning as another teaching and learning method which is different from the traditional classroom setting that you are all used to. In the distance education mode, you are not with the teacher in person, so take your time, relax, listen to the teacher, take down notes and visit the following links for any questions or answers to your questions. Take it in your stride. This is Cameroon's solution to COVID-19 and beyond. Professor Nalovalyonga, Minister of Secondary Education.
Welcome to this learning session. I'm Felix Forti, the mathematics didactics teacher for level 3 students. This lesson is intended for students who are preparing to write the KPM, those who are in level 3, and those who are just coming to do 1 year course. Most of the level 3 students are those who probably have been there for the past 2 years, or those who have been there for the past 3 years, and they are up now in level 3, and they are about to write the KPM. And those for 1 year course are those who are just coming to do 1 year and write the KPM. At the end of our last lesson, we had a take-home exercise. Remember, in our last lesson, we reviewed the content of didactics of mathematics in teacher training colleges. At this moment, we are going to look at the one for primary school. And in that exercise, you were to look at the primary school mathematics and write down 5 topics that you ever came across. All of us have passed through primary school. We did a good number of topics. We were expected to come up with 5 of these topics. These are possible topics that we came across. With so many, we cannot enumerate all here. But the main ones that we could remember all the time are sets, numbers, we did addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, shapes, and many others. We were expected to list just 5 of them, and we see here many. And I know can remember many of them that we ever did when we were in the primary school. Our lesson of today is on a course outline for mathematics in the primary school. In this lesson, we are going to review all what mathematics is about in the primary school, all what is being taught to the primary school children. You know, as a student teacher going out, you are supposed to be empowered with content and knowledge to be able to teach primary school children. So in this lesson, we are going to see all of that, all of the content, and this will enable you to handle primary school children when you meet them in the field. This plan will guide us through our lesson. We'll begin by looking at the objectives of this lesson, and by the objectives, we are looking at the outcome. What are we to benefit at the end of this lesson? Prerequisite now is what we are supposed to know that will help us go through this lesson. We shall see some of these things that are necessary and will enable us to go through this lesson successfully. We'll begin the lesson by stating a real life situation. A real life situation is a situation that brings into play real life, what you encounter in the field when you'll be teaching the children. So in this case now, we'll come across a situation which you'll be able to resolve by the time we go through the lesson. And then we shall get into the lesson proper and see all what we are going to study under the course outline for mathematics in the primary school. We'll end the lesson with an application exercise. This exercise is to assess us, to review and see how much we've understood the lesson. Equally, we end with a take-home exercise. At home, you do this exercise and you bring it in the next lesson. The objectives of this lesson as student teachers is for you to show mastery of primary school mathematics. You will realize that in order to teach primary school mathematics, you need to understand the concepts very well and to show mastery of it. So by the end of this lesson, you would have gone through all what is needed for you to teach in the primary school so far as mathematics is concerned, and you should be able to show mastery of it and to use it in the teaching and learning of mathematics in the primary school. At this moment, what do you know that can help you to learn this course content of mathematics in the primary school? All of us have gone through the primary school. We have basic notions of primary school mathematics, which we can always remember at any time. We know many of them. There are things that you know, like counting, addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, shapes, and so on. All of these things, you can always recall them. They will help us in this lesson. What is the importance of mathematics to learners? And what are the concepts taught in mathematics? Here we are going to see, or to revise, or to remind ourselves, to recall what we know about mathematics, what we have been learning about mathematics, how important is mathematics to learners, and what are some of the concepts that have been taught so far as mathematics is concerned. So you don't just teach mathematics like that, you need to understand how useful it is and what are you going to teach to the learners. Let us look at the importance of mathematics. Why do we teach mathematics? Why is it important for the children to learn mathematics? You will realize that mathematics develops in the children creativity, logical, and inferential thinking. They will now need to learn the sense of initiative and to develop problem-solving skills. You see that mathematics always deals with problems, and most of the problems are real-life problems. And they have to apply mathematics to solve these problems. And in that case now, they will develop logical and inferential thinking. A good number of concepts have been taught in mathematics. And these concepts have been grouped into five main groups. And the groups are sets and logic, numbers and relations, measurement, geometry, statistics, and graphs. All what we teach in mathematics fall under one of this group. It can be sets and logic, it can be issues of numbers and numeration, it can be issues of measurement, something that concerns geometry, or aspects of statistics and graphs. This problem situation is going to usher us into the lesson. This is a real life problem, a problem that you will definitely encounter when you are carrying out your duty as a teacher. In the course of this lesson, always remember this problem and will discover a solution to this problem in the course of our lesson. It reads, your junior classmate tells you that they will soon go on internship, this time around to a primary school. Anxious to take mathematics but not confident of a mastery of the Cameroon primary school curriculum comes to you for assistance. I read again. Your junior classmate tells you they will soon go for internship, this time around to a primary school. Anxious to take mathematics, but not confident of her mastery of the Cameroon primary school curriculum, comes to you for assistance. With reference to the Cameroon primary school curriculum, one, identify the domain of mathematics. Two, identify the course key acquired from the course. Three, outline the terminal learning outcomes for mathematics. And four, outline the components of mathematics. Keep this in your mind. You will discover answers to this as we go through the lesson. Let us go into our lesson proper and look at the domains of mathematics. In the Cameroon Primary School curriculum, there are five domains. The first domain is that of basic knowledge. Mathematics falls in this domain. It is a fundamental domain to the development of other domains. Many subjects are included in this domain, like mathematics, English, and parasubjects are for honor sciences and technology. And what is done in this domain will develop literacy and numeracy skills in the learners. Basic knowledge domain is a strong foundation for education. It accounts for 60% of the work done in the primary school, and consequently, 60% of the time used in the primary school is attributed to this domain. Can we get to see how important is this domain with respect to the other domains? When you learn mathematics, you acquire some core skills. The core skills for mathematics go along with core skills for other science subjects, so they go together. And we put these core skills under the use of basic notions in mathematics, science, and technology. Equally along the line, the children will learn lifelong skills. Lifelong skills are skills that they learn and they remain in them forever. Take for instance, teach them counting. They will learn how to count, and all through their life, they will continue to count. Even to write numbers, even to add, those are lifelong skills that remain with them. So when you teach mathematics, you develop these lifelong skills, and you develop in them basic notions in mathematics, science, and technology. Seven terminal learning outcomes are achieved by the end of the course. Pupils are expected to solve problems involving sets and logic. We will realize that these terminal outcomes are developed from those content areas that we had earlier seen. Learners too should be able to solve problems involving numbers and operations. Learners should be able to solve problems involving measurement, construct different geometric shapes, categorize statistics and graphs, and they should be able to apply this knowledge of mathematics in their daily life situations. Of course, when we teach mathematics, we intend to develop interest in mathematics in the learners. In the Cameroon Primary School curriculum, mathematics has been broken down into five components. And here we have the five components. First one is sets and logic. The second one is numbers and operations. The third is measurement and size. We have geometry and space, graphs and statistics. If you open to the curriculum, you will see these five components. And the content under these five components are elaborated. They have been put in that order from sets right up to graphs and statistics. Let us look at the components in details. What content is taught under each component? We start with the first component, which is sets and logic. What are the content? What is taught under sets and logic? We start by identification of sets and logic. Children should be able to identify sets and name them. Children should be able to differentiate between the different types of sets. They should be able to combine sets, to come up with union, and to come up with the intersection of sets. And the children should be able to represent sets in diagrams. And these diagrams are known as Venn diagrams. We go to the second component, which has to do with numbers, numerations, and number operations. Here, the children learn about numbers, the different types of numbers, whole numbers, decimals, and fractions. They equally learn number bases, and they carry out calculations using the different operations in mathematics, like addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division. Then they should be able to work with numbers to come up with their factors and multiples, and use numbers calculate ratio, proportion, and percentages. The third component is measurement. They will study the different measurement units, which are length, mass, capacity, time, and money. And they will equally learn the different measurement instruments that are used to carry out these measurements. The children will learn how to calculate areas, perimeter, volumes of geometric shape, and how to calculate speed, time, and distance. The fourth component is geometry. Geometry has to do with lines and angles. Therefore, the student will learn how to draw lines, curves, horizontal lines, vertical lines, parallel lines, and perpendicular lines. These lines, when combined, will give angles. And these lines, further combined, will give us shapes. And the common shapes that we will come across are three-sided shapes like a triangle and four-sided shapes known as quadrilaterals. Shapes with many more sides are grouped under what is called polygons. In that case, we can have five-sided shapes, six-sided shapes, seven-sided shapes, eight-sided shapes, all of them form under polygons. We're going to look at dimensions. In dimensions, we are talking about width, height, and length. When these three dimensions are combined, we have three-dimensional shapes. If only two dimensions are combined, we have two-dimensional shapes. And the fifth component of mathematics is graphs and statistics. Children will learn how to collect simple data around the class, around them, and to manage this data. They will learn how to put this data into frequency tables. Frequency tables is a way of arranging the data in an orderly manner that somebody can read and understand the data. And then they will equally learn how to put this data in a graphical form to draw graphs. And the common graph that they are going to draw is a bar chart or a pie chart. What are the evaluation criteria? How do we now see that these children now understand what they have learned? In it, they will be grouped, they can group issues, they can match, they can classify objects and numbers in sets using different attributes. You will realize that these evaluation criteria move in line with different components. So that in the case of the first component, it has to do with sets and logic. There they will bring grouping, matching, classifying, and differentiating the different types of sets. And we know sets are differentiated following different attributes. Equally, they will learn how to represent sets using symbols and figures. When they move ahead now, they will learn how to use symbols and signs in drawing diagrams and ordering in a consistent manner. They should equally be able to identify and build geometric shapes. As I said earlier, you see that the criteria moves with the component. They will be able now to manipulate statistical information on groups. When they collect data, they should be able to manipulate it and put it in frequency tables and in an orderly manner, and use appropriate operations and formula. We came across the different mathematical operations, which are addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division. Of course, when they learn figures, you should be able to associate quantities to figures and symbols. Remember, figures deal with symbols, and these symbols are used to represent quantities. Proper use of mathematics tools, like tools that they use in measurement, tools that they use in drawing, things like circles, tools that are used in drawing angles, just to name a few. Equally, you will now be able to solve meaningful daily life problems. You know, there are many daily life problems that involve mathematics. So they apply this knowledge of mathematics in solving meaningful real life problems. When you open to the Cameroon Primary School curriculum and go straight to mathematics, you see the content being outlined in this manner. It is put in a table. In that table, there are four columns. And along the table, you see the different five components. For each component, you see the unit or content under it. You see the expected learning outcomes. you see the teaching learning strategies, and you see possible didactic materials suitable for that component. So it's a broad table with all these things there. Along it, you start with the first component, which is sets and logic. The next component is numbers and operations. Then the other component is measurement and size. And then we'll move to geometry and space, and graphs and statistics. And then we'll go to the columns now. You see the first column there that has to do with the unit and content. We have seen our details of the content under each of these domains. So if you open to the curriculum, you'll see that content will spell out under this first column. And again, in the curriculum, the expected learning outcome for each content is spelled out. Suggested teaching learning strategies are equally spelled out here, and possible didactic material for that content are equally enumerated there. So you have all those details in the curriculum. If you check it, you find it there in that manner. And the curriculum will describe the class. You know, we have class 1 up to class 6. So there now you will see for each class what it entails. The subjects in the primary school are weighted differently. Here is the weighting and time allocation for mathematics. We have single shift and double shift systems in our school. And within a whole year, for level 1 and 2, mathematics is expected to be covered in 69 hours. And in level 3, it is covered in 103 and a half hours. In a week, for level 1 and 2, mathematics is covered in 3 hours. And for level 3, it takes 4.5 hours. So from this weighting, you can begin to see the importance of this subject in the primary school system. All the subjects do not have the same weightings. The mathematics is like one of them with the highest weighting. Priority is for languages, and mathematics comes second. So far, we've come across the following items. We saw how mathematics can develop essential skills in learners. We equally saw that mathematics belongs to domain one, and that domain one is that of basic knowledge. Of course, in that domain, you equally have other subjects. Mathematics is one of them. We equally realize that mathematics share the same expected core skills as other science and technology subjects. And this core skill is the use of basic notion in mathematics, sciences, and technology. We realize that mathematics is put into 5 components. And these 5 components are sets and logic, numbers and operation, measurement, geometry, graphs, and statistics. By the end of the course, we would have achieved 7 terminal learning outcomes. From studying mathematics all through the year, the children would have achieved 7 terminal learning outcomes. We came across a different evaluation criteria, and we saw that the evaluation criteria will move from component to component. When we look at the weightings of mathematics, we will realize that for 1 week, mathematics is attributed 3 hours for level 1 and 2, and 4.5 hours for level 3. And of course, for the year in level 1 and 2, it has 69 hours, and for level 3, 103.5 hours. If you open to your curriculum, you see this detailed content for mathematics. So it will be advisable that before you go ahead, look for the curriculum, try to acquire one, and open to it, you'll see the details of all what we've been saying. Let us look at this application exercise that will enable us to find out whether all what we have been saying is understood. It reads, a class 3 teacher has to explain a mathematics lesson. He comes to you because he hasn't a good mastery of the primary school curriculum. I read again. A class teacher has to plan a mathematics lesson. He comes to you because he hasn't a good mastery of the primary school mathematics syllabus. Discuss the elements of two components of the primary school mathematics syllabus. Outline the core skill for mathematics. So, can you remember from what we've been doing in this lesson to be able to enable you to answer these questions? You have a few minutes to reflect on it, and then we see what the hand will discuss the answers. Let us look at the answers. The components of mathematics, we'll take two of them. As expected, we'll have just to take. The first one was sets and logic. And the content there was to identify sets and name them, distinguish some types of sets, and to be able to put sets together to come up with union and intersection, and then to represent sets diagrammatically in Venn diagrams. Of course, the second one is on numbers, numerations, and operations. Here we are dealing with numbers, all the different types of numbers, decimals and fractions. And then we'll work with numbers, doing calculations, and these calculations involve four main operations: addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division. The core skill for mathematics that is developed is the use of basic notion in mathematics, science, and technology. And of course, when we learn mathematics, we develop lifelong skill. As we saw in the course of the lesson, this basic notion in mathematics is combined with other science and technology subjects. We have here a take-home assignment. Do this assignment at home and bring it in our next lesson. It reads, with reference to the Cameroon Primary School Curriculum for Primary 3, outline the components for mathematics. Choose a component for mathematics and state the elements in it. I read again. With reference to the curriculum for Primary 3, outline the components for mathematics. D. Choose a component for mathematics and state its elements. This requires that we should look for the curriculum. If we don't have it, try to obtain one. And in it, we'll find answers to this problem. This lesson was made possible thanks to the following documents. The Cameroon Primary School Curriculum that came out in 2018. The Official Syllabus for Teacher Training College that came out in 2014. And the Teacher's Guide for Cameroon Primary School Curriculum that came out in 2020. Our next lesson is on sets and logic for primary schools. Here we shall see details of what is done under sets and logic in the primary school.
Ona tege minga matege nyum, ona tege majang matege ndom, mane tambia ninyane njubyayen, ngani bana matege mot, ngani lakiri watege ndong, esu kinambia dinkido, mane tambia ninyane njubyayen, tamtama mote tamzabike, tamtama tonge tamzabike, tamtama mote tamzabike, mane tambia ninyane njubyayen.